You'll always be there for each other.
Barefoot is and can be sweet as honey. Sometimes you'll find they might be just plain funny.
The Berenstain Bears. The Berenstain Bears.
Can a bear's vacation with more rain than sun end up being the one that's most fun? Okay, everyone set?
Are we forgetting something?
Brother!
Well, we can't forget brother.
After all, this is a family vacation.
Grab the camera. I want to take lots of pictures.
Oh, there will be lots to take pictures of, I'm sure.
You betcha. A whole week in our own mountain cabin, no crowded beaches and tourist traps. This year, we'll be living off the land.
Catching fish for breakfast.
Picking fresh bumbleberries for lunch.
And the mountain sunsets will be spectacular.
Yes, sirree. This is going to be...
The best vacation ever.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Uh-oh. Looks like we're a little flat. And I don't mean our singing. No problem. I'll just get the spare out of the trunk. To get the spare tire, I have to unpack everything. Oh, well, we're not gonna let a flat tire spoil the best vacation ever. I'll have this changed in no time. Huh? Hey, where did it go?
It's getting away!
Hey! That took a little longer than I thought, but it's done.
Oh. It certainly is pretty up here.
And just smell that fresh mountain air.
Ew.
Yuck.
Blech. That's not mountain air, Papa.
That's skunk.
Ah! Hop in! Our cabin should be right around the bend.
There it is! There's our cabin!
Oh, it's perfect!
I don't see any wires, which means no electricity.
That's the last thing we need on a wilderness live-off-the-land vacation. We've got the sun and the moon for lighting and the breeze for air conditioning.
And we certainly couldn't have a better air-conditioned bathroom.
Hey, sister, the bathroom's outside. Cool.
Real cool, especially at night.
I'm not gonna let a cabin full of leaves spoil our best vacation ever. Huh? What's this? Whoa! Ah! Wild animals! Run for your lives!
Say cheese!
This is just like a clubhouse.
And now that we've got it all cleaned up, who's for picking fresh bumbleberries?
Me!
Me too!
An outdoors bear like myself knows that the juiciest, best-tasting bumbleberries are found in the thickest part of the forest.
And the mosquitoes know that's just where the juiciest, best-tasting bears are found, too.
Look, Papa! Bumbleberries!
Oh, my. They do look delicious.
Ooh, especially those ones.
Careful, it's slippery.
Don't worry. When it comes to bumbleberry picking, I'm a mountain goat. Oh! 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 Whoa!
Cheese!
Bumbleberry?
Ew. Bleh!
Oh,
say
sour.
Cheese!
We won't let a few sour berries, some leaves, and some mud spoil our best vacation ever. Get ready for the best fish dinner ever. Nothing wrong with this boat. You like submarines.
Cheese!
Why is the water all green, Mama?
It's because of all the weeds, sister.
We're not gonna let a leaky boat and few weeds spoil our best vacation ever. Oh, my hook's caught on the weeds. I can't pull it loose. Whoa!
Say cheese.
So what if we didn't catch any fish? Here it is. Everything I need to cook up my famous wilderness stew.
Looks interesting.
Yep, some roots and bark and a few leaves. And don't worry, it'll look a lot more appetizing when it's done. Stew time! Here's to living off the land.
Blech!
Oh!
Ah!
Oh, good thing you packed these baked beans and honeycomb, Mama.
Good things to have along when the fish aren't biting.
Or when my stew gets rained out. Oh, it looks like our after-dinner mountain sunset got rained out, too.
Then we'll just get up nice and early and enjoy a glorious sunrise.
A great idea. Let's turn in so we can get up at the crack of dawn.
Are you sure you're going to be okay on the floor?
Oh, you betcha. There's nothing like a wilderness bed for a wilderness vacation. Oh, just listen to that silence. No traffic, no city noises, just peace and quiet. Not gonna let a few animals and a little leak ruin the best vacation ever. Vacation ever has been nothing but the worst vacation ever. Nothing has gone right. The cabin, the fishing, the berries, the stew. It was all supposed to be fun.
But, Papa, we are having fun.
Lots of fun.
And we thought you were having fun, too. See?
Well, I guess I did look pretty funny. That was some ride. Oh, look at that one. Boy, did I get a soaker. Look at this. I guess I was looking at things all wrong. Seeing it this way, this is the best vacation ever.
You betcha.
Sometimes the difference between having a bad time and having a great time just depends on how you look at it.
And you know what the best part of this vacation is? It's not over yet. Now, who wants to go find some sweet bumbleberries for breakfast?
Yay!
Let's go.
But we're still in our pajamas.
Aw, so what? We're on vacation. There's nobody here but us. Oh, and don't forget the camera.
Both grown-ups and cubs learn a lesson about how families work best when they work problems out.
Oh, wow. What next?
Your jigsaw?
Jammed again. But this time the motor blew. I guess I was working it too hard, trying to get this big chair order finished by the weekend. Now I'll never get it done. Boy, am I having a rough day.
You and me both. I've been cutting pieces of cloth all day for Mrs. Honeypot's Christmas quilts, but I don't really know how much to do until she phones with her order. Oh, that must be her.
No ideas for our school play yet, Lizzie. But I think Brother is working on something upstairs.
Is that Mrs. Honeypot?
It's Lizzie.
Quick, I need to use the phone.
But I just got on it.
This is important. I have to call the hardware store.
Sorry, Lizzie. Gotta go.
Oh, they'll be closing any minute. Oh, too late.
Maybe someone's advertising a used jigsaw for sale in the newspaper.
Good idea. Oh, where's the for sale section? What are you doing with the paper?
Using it to keep the paint off my desk.
You should have asked.
But no one in this family reads the for sale section.
Well, I'm reading it now.
Did you find it? Oh, Mrs. Honeypot!
Hi, Lizzie. Uh-oh. I'll call you back.
Oh, you know I've been waiting all day for the mayor's wife to call, and you're always on the phone with Lizzie. You have all day tomorrow to talk to her, so please stay off the phone. And it's your turn to set the table.
Aww.
We have to stay after school today, Mama.
Yes, we have to work on our play for the Night of Plays night.
The Night of Plays? You never mentioned it. This note is over a week old.
I guess we forgot to give it to you.
It's probably too late to get tickets. Every parent in town goes to the Night of Plays, and we promised Gran and Gramps we'd get them tickets, too.
Oh, the school bus.
Bye.
Bye.
Hello? Mrs. Honeypot, thanks for calling. Oh, that's quite all right.
Boy, you sure hung the phone up fast last night.
Oh, don't remind me.
Okay. Brother and I have saved the day. We figured out a play we can do for the Night of Plays. Ready? Frankenbear! Roar!
Ew!
And the return of Frankenbear.
No way.
Besides, Too Tall is going to do Dracula Bear.
You look like Papa last night.
What she means is, Papa and Mama were kind of grumpy last night.
Just because Brother took the paper without asking.
And Sister used the phone a few times.
Oh, that's why you hung up so fast.
No matter what we did, it was wrong.
I know that feeling.
It's really hard being a cub sometimes.
That's it! We could do a play about what it's like to be a cub.
Yeah, about how tough it is.
That's a great idea.
And I know what we can call it. The Trouble with Grown-Ups.
Yes! Yes!
My, you two have been busy lately. We've hardly seen you.
We've been working on our play.
We can't wait to see what it's about.
You know, earlier this week, we were a little hard on you. It's just that, well, with Papa's broken saw and my quilt orders, well, we'd like to make it up to you by taking you out tomorrow after the play.
A special dinner?
Can we pick the place?
You betcha.
Sister and Brother's play should be next. I wonder what it's going to be about.
Our last play for tonight features Brother and Sister Bear, Cousin Fred, and Lizzie Bruin. It's called The Trouble with Parents.
Where's my newspaper, son?
I have it, Papa. I'm using it so you don't get any paint on this nice new table you made in your workshop.
What? You didn't ask me!
But you never read this section, Papa.
That doesn't matter! Oh, you cubs make me so mad!
Hi, Terry. How are you?
Is that Mrs. Waterspout, dear?
No, Mama. It is my friend, Terry.
You know I'm waiting for a very important telephone call.
I'm sorry, Mama, but I didn't...
You cubs talk on the phone a zillion times a day. It makes me want to scream!
Do your homework! Clean your rooms!
Stop fooling around! Pick up your clothes!
You know, most of the time, our parents are pretty great.
But sometimes it's pretty tough being a cub when parents seem to blow their tops without a good reason.
The good thing is, sooner or later, parents grow out of it and become grandparents.
And grandparents never blow their tops at their grandcubs.
So you really liked the play?
We sure did. Not only did we enjoy it, it helped us to see that it's not always easy being a cub.
But it goes the other way, too, you know. Sometimes it's not easy being a parent.
I think being a parent is the easiest thing there is.
Yeah. Parents don't have anyone telling them what to do, and they can do anything they want.
Really easy.
Hooray for weekends!
Do you like our costumes? I spent half the night making them.
We thought that maybe you'd like to be the parents today, and we could be the cubs. Oh, but no driving the car.
This means we get to tell them what to do.
Cool. We'll be right back.
Well, what's for breakfast?
We didn't think about that part.
I'll get the cereal. You get the juice.
And berries and toast, too.
Aww. Hey, where did they go?
I guess they're finished.
But who's gonna clean the mess?
I'll wash you dry. Phew. I thought that was going to take all day.
All I want to do now is watch TV.
But we want you to play tag, Papa.
And hide and seek, Mama.
But it's raining outside.
So we want to play in the house. Can we, huh?
But you never let us jump on the furniture.
That's right. We are the parents.
So why not? That was fun, Cubs.
You betcha.
Oh, the rain stopped. I'm going to go play with Lizzie.
And I'm going to Freddy's.
Me too.
Me too.
Ah, but you can't. You're the parents, remember?
And this room is a mess. Bye.
I'll get the broom.
That was a lot of work.
Let's take a break. I'm beat.
What's for lunch?
Huh?
We're starving.
And after lunch, can you fix my bike, Papa?
And can you sew the rip in my jumper, Mama?
And could we have our allowances so we can go to the movies?
And what's for supper?
Okay, we give up.
We understand that sometimes it's hard to be parents, too.
So can we please just be the Cubs and you be the parents again?
Please?
Oh, we thought you'd never ask.
Oh, this running around playing has tired us right out.
From now on, I'll try harder not to hog the phone.
And we'll try harder to be more patient.
When things get busy and stressful around the house.
And if I need the newspaper, I'll get it from the recycle box.
Just think. Someday, you probably will be parents with cubs all your own to take care of.
I think maybe we'll skip that part.
And just become grandparents.